Yes, everyone outside there that is watching us on BTN TV. Again, today it is Teacher Friday in the studio, delivering a lesson in mathematics as usual. For those who have been following us, they know what we have been doing since the time began up to the time we are. So well, as I've said, those who have been following, they know us as Teacher Fred. I'm going to handle a mathematics lesson again in the studio today about mixtures. I said we are going to deal with unit 6. After unit 6 is when we shall go to another unit. So we are looking towards the end of our unit 6, which deals with the proportions, percentages, ratios, and mixtures. So we are done with the percentages, we are done with the ratios, we are done with the proportions. Finally, I want us to look at mixtures. And once we complete mixtures, we shall come to an end of the unit. So before that, I want us to look at the topic for today. I want us to look at the subtopic for today, which says finding average price of mixtures. I want us to understand this first of all. When somebody talks about the mixture, what comes to your mind? A mixture. A mixture simply means getting some two different things of different kinds and you put them together, or more than two, mixing things. For example, I can get beans and I mix with the maize. That is a mixture. I can also get sugar, I mix with the salt. That's a mixture. So a mixture simply means bringing two things or more than two things of different kinds and you mix them up. That's what we understand by a mixture. So when you see the word mixture, simply know that we are going to talk about mixing items of different qualities, of different colors, and so on. For instance, let's look at example one and we see what does it require us to do. Example one says, Joy mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which cost 400 francs per kilo, with 10 kilograms of another type, which cost 250 francs per kilogram. What is the average price? What is the average price of a mixture? What is the average price? What is the average? What is the average price of a mixture? What is the average price of a mixture per kilo or per kilogram? So they have told us when you look at the first type, we have two types here. The first type of curry powder, it is costing 400 francs. Then at the same time, we have another type which is costing us 250 francs. So first of all, what we're going to do here, we are going to use two methods, and out of those two methods, let me begin with the one whereby we are required to request for permission to represent these types of powder or curry powder. So we shall say, let the first one, the first type, let the first type, let the first type B, A. So the first type we are going to call it A. Then the second type, we shall also let the second type be B. So I'm going to refer to the first type of curry powder that was costing us 400 francs to be represented by A. And at the same time, we shall represent the type B, which was the second type, with B letter. So I'll come and have my simple table down here. I'll say I'll have type this side. I'll have type. And under type, I have type A. I have also type B. At the same time, I need also a mixture. Okay? So when you look at this, we have types here of curry powder. The first type is A, the second type is B, and when you mix the two, we shall come out with what we call a mixture. That's why we are seeing this word mixture. So when you mix A and B, we shall come out with a mixture. Now under this mixture, I'll have my simple table here. Be using a ruler to draw all this. Don't use a free hand. Free hand is not entertained. So after drawing this, want us to divide this also. We say type A stands on its own. Type B stands also on its own. Then we have mixture. When you get type A and type B, you will come out with a mixture. Then from here, we shall come to what we call quantity. I'm writing it in short. Quantity. Quantity simply means the number of kilograms. How many did this person buy? So when we look at this, Joy mixed 5 kilograms of carbowder, and these five are the ones we are referring as to the first type, which is being represented by A. So its quantity was 5 kilograms. So I will put here 5 kilograms. And then I will continue. I will come here. I say unit cost. Unit cost. When I talk about unit cost, unit simply mean single or one. So unit costs are meaning how many how much is being paid for only 1 kilogram. That is what we are meaning by unit cost. So unit means one. Unit cost, what you have paid for only one. So from there we shall continue and say how much for the first carry powder. Joy mixed 5 kilograms of carry powder, which cost 400. So there were five, but each of them, each kilogram from there was costing 400 francs only. Then after there, what will follow? We continue with our statement. We are just interpreting the statement and we fill it directly here in the table. So let's come to B. When we continue with our statement from where we ended, they said Joy mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which cost 400 francs per kilogram, with 10 kilograms of another type. And that other type is what we are referring to, type B. That is now the second type. And how many kilograms did this person mix? Joy mixed 10 kilograms. This is now the second type. She mixed 10 kilograms. After mixing 10 kilograms, we continue with the statement of another type, which cost how much? It was costing 250 francs per kilo. Per kilo simply means one. Per kilo, each kilo, it simply means one. So we shall say it was costing 250 francs. That is now the price of only 1 kilogram. Then from there, after identifying the quantity, we identify the unit cost. Then after identifying the unit cost, we shall come to what we call amount. Be using a ruler, don't use a free hand. We shall come to what we call amount or total amount. Total amount. So want us to identify that. We want us to identify the total amount that has been used for all the items. Total amount simply means we are going to get the unit cost times the quantity. Then we see how much did somebody, or how much was somebody supposed to use on only one type. So we are going to identify for each type. But before we identify the amount for each type, let's look at this. How much did this person used to spend on 1 kilogram of type A? Type A, she mixed 5 kilograms, but remember each kilogram was costing 400. So if she mixed 5 kilograms, how much was supposed to be paid for the 5 kilograms is what we are meaning by the total amount. So we shall say, if 1 kilogram is costing 400 francs, then we shall get 400 francs multiplied by the number of kilograms that Joy mixed. And how many kilograms did Joy mix? We know very well that Joy mixed 5 kilograms. So we shall get 5 kilograms multiplied by 400 francs to come out with the total amount that was supposed to be allocated for type A. So we shall say 5 times 4, which will give us 20. How many zeros are here? We have just got this 5 times 4, which has given us 20. Then we have 2 zeros. Then I will add here my 2 zeros, and this will become francs. So when you get 5 times 400, you will come out with 2,000 francs. And this 2,000 francs is the money that is supposed to be used or spent on 5 kilograms of the first type. So the first type costs 2,000 francs. And this 2,000 francs is for 5 kilograms. Then after identifying that, we come to the second type, that is type B. Type B, it has got 10 kilograms, and each kilogram, that is what we are calling unit cost, each kilogram, 1 kilogram, is costing 250. Now, if 1 kilogram is 250, what about 10? How much do you think somebody will spend on 10 kilograms? We shall get the amount for 1 kilogram. We multiply by the number of kilograms that somebody has bought or has mixed. So each kilogram was 250, but it was mixed. She mixed how many kilograms? 10. So we shall get 10 kilograms times the amount for 1 kilogram, which is 250. So when we multiply out, we shall come out with 2,500 francs. That is what it means. So it means that type B only, it was costing 2,500 francs for 10 kilograms. But the first type, they were only 5, costing 2,000. So let's look at this. When you talk about the mixture, if somebody got A, mixture A, and I mean type A, and added to type B, then it means if I have type A here, as 10 kilograms or 10 or 5, let's get the quantity of the first type, what somebody brought, then we get also another second type, we add them. Okay, now we are going to mix. We know each type, we have type A, we are now going to mix with the type B. When you get type A and you mix with the type B, we shall come out with the mixture. So we shall begin with this. We shall come with the quantity. When somebody gets 5 kilograms of type B, then mixes with the 10 kilograms of type B. How many kilograms will this person come out with? If you have got A, they are 5 kilograms in A. So you have carried 5 kilograms from A, you have mixed, or you get 5 kilograms of A, you put in a bucket, then at the same time you go to B, you also get 10 kilograms, you come and add in the packet where you have put already 5 kilograms. How many kilograms will you come out with? You will end up by having 15 kilograms. So we shall get type A, 5 kilograms, we mix with the B, 10 kilograms. All those 10, as you mix, kilograms will increase. So we are going to get 5 kilograms plus 10 kilograms, which will give us 15 kilograms. So the mixture is made out of 15 kilograms. We have now mixed 15 kilograms right now because we had 5 for type A, then we have got 10 for type B. So if we have got 10 for type B and 5 for type A, then when we bring them together in one packet or one tin, it means we shall come out with 15 kilograms. Now that is the number or the quantity of a mixture. Remember, the quantity of a mix of type A only, it was 5. Then the quantity of type B, it was also 10. Separately. But now when you bring A and B, you put it together, they become a mixture. When they become a mixture, as you know, A came with 5 kilograms, then B is also coming with 10 kilograms. When you put it together as a mixture, just know the quantity will raise, or kilograms will raise. to how many? From 5 with B10, then we shall come out with 15 kilograms. After raising 15 kilograms, we shall continue. We don't know how much were they selling each kilogram. Is what the question wants us to find out. What is the average price of a mixture per kilo? So they want us to find the amount that each kilo was costing. We don't know. But remember this, you know the amount that you spent on type B. How much was it? It was 2,000. 5 kilograms, it is 2,000. As we have worked out, then when we come to B, 10 kilograms is equal to 2,500. So we want to see, if you get the money for type A and you add on the money for type B, then it means that amount you will spend on A and the amount you will spend on B, that will come out as a total amount for our mixture. Because type A is supposed to be spent on 2,000. That's type A. Then type B, you are supposed to spend there 2,500. So when you bring 2,000 with the 2,500, you put it together. That's what we shall call a mixture. So a mixture will cost us this amount. Zero. We are now adding 0, 5, 4. Why are we adding? We are making it a mixture. We are now finding the mixture, the amount that is supposed to be spent on the mixture alone. Because type A, it is for 2,000. Type B, it is 2,500. Now, when you bring 2,000 for type A, you add 2,500 for type B, you'll come out with 4,500 for the mixture. Now, if you want to buy 15 kilograms of what they have mixed A and B, you will pay 4,500 if you buy 15 kilograms of what they have mixed. In most cases, this is what always happens outside there. Some of you, when you want to buy flour for porridge, mostly known as chikoma porridge or flour, when you went in your shops outside there, you always say, "I want flour for porridge." They get millet flour, they mix for you with the sorghum flour, they mix for you with the masaka, they mix for you with the posho maize flour. So you end up by going with a variety of them, but being mixed up. So these shopkeepers that are mixing for you, they have already calculated the price of what you are taking. That's what we are calling a mixture. So if you go somewhere and you want, let's say, 5 kilograms of maize flour, they mix it for you like 10 kilograms of soya flour. If maize is costing this, then soya is costing this, you'll end up by paying this amount of money. Sometimes some of you, when you're going to the shop, they always tell you, go and buy for us cassava flour, 2 kilograms. Then you also buy for us 5 kilograms of maize flour, but they have to mix. So when they mix, you realize that you'll get the amount of cassava flour. If you have bought your cassava flour, you'll calculate the amount you spend on cassava flour. Maybe that is, if you bought 5 kilograms and each is 1,000, you'll first calculate that 5,000. Then you come to maize flour, you also calculate 10,000, maybe at 5,000. So you add all the money together. Just like now, when we come to this question here, Joy mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which costs 400 per each. One of it costs 400 per each. Now remember this Joy here. Let's now say this Joy is now a shopkeeper. She is a shopkeeper who mixed all this. So after her going somewhere on the after her buying everything, she had to mix such that she can sell people a mixture. Okay, so they will have, Joy will have mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which is costing this. So the 5 kilograms she mixed in B, it was, the 5 kilograms was costing 2,000. Then the 10 kilograms of B, which was costing 250 per kilogram, all the 10 kilograms will be for 2,500. Now, when we come to the mixture, we have said 5 plus 10, it is now our mixture. For A and B, you have now bought 15 kilograms. So when they give you 15 kilograms, how much are you going to pay? 15 kilograms, you are supposed to pay 4,500. You are supposed to pay 4,500. And how are you getting this 4,500? This 4,500 is coming in this way. Type A, it is for 2,000, all the 5 kilograms. Type B is 2,500 for 10 kilograms. So the mixture, when you buy A and B and they mix it for you, you will pay 4,500. And after that, you ask yourself, if they mixed this mixture, if they mixed these two types, 15 kilograms, you are paying this. What about 1 kilogram of what they have mixed? Now is what they want us to find out here. That is what they are calling unit cost. That's what they are saying. What is the average price of a mixture per kilo? Now 1 kilo is costing how much here? We don't know. Is what they want us to find out. Now for us to be in position to find out the number, the amount that is spent on only one kilogram of a mixture, we shall get the amount of a mixture, that is 4,500. We divide by the number of kilograms to come out with the amount of only 1 kilogram. So I'll come here and say, 4,500. I'm now getting this amount. Then I divide by this number of kilograms. I may not write in this box, but that's what we are doing. We are getting 4,500, the amount of which was spent on the mixture. Then we divide by the number of kilograms which are there, and they are 15 kilograms. So when we divide the amount we are going to come out with, it is what we are referring to as unit cost for only 1 kilogram of a mixture. So I will say, by 15, 1. How many groups of 15 can go into 45? They are 3 groups. So I will say, 3. And if there are 3, how many zeros are here? By 15, these 2 zeros, I will just copy them up there. So this simply means 1 kilogram of a mixture will cost us 300 francs. 300 francs. So I will say, therefore, unit cost of a mixture is 3,000 francs. Then from there you'll get your ruler and underline this. Let's look at this, and we call this as our first method. This is our first method, or method one. Want us to explain it more such that we may come out with something. Now when we look at our table here, this table has summarized everything. We have types, and our types, we have type A and type B. Then from there, type A, when you mix A with B, it gives us what we call a mixture. Now, type A, we had 5 kilograms. Type A, we had 5 kilograms. So we shall get the 5 kilograms, which was costing how much? How much were they selling each kilogram? They are selling 1 kilogram at 400. So for us to find out the amount which was spent on all the 5 kilograms of curry powder, we shall have 400 times 5, which will give us 2,000 francs. Then we shall come to the second type, which was 10 kilograms, and each kilogram was costing 250 francs. Then from there, it will give us 2,500 francs. That is the amount that one person is supposed to spend on B only, if you have gone to buy only B. But if you have gone to buy A and B, and you want them to mix it for you, then If you buy 5 kilograms of type A and you buy 10 kilograms of type B, it means you would have bought 15 kilograms at once. That's why you find out that the quantity of a mixture is 15 kilograms. But we didn't know the amount of 1 kilogram. So we came to here. We said if type A you spent 2000, type B you spent 2500, then what about the mixture? The mixture, when you buy A and B, you'll spend 4500. When you spend 4500, then we shall use this 4500, we divide by the number of kilograms we are having here to know how much is spent on a mixture. And now a mixture, each kilogram will be costing 300 francs. That is the money that you can spend on only 1 kilogram. Only 1 kilogram, you'll pay 300. This was method one. I want to go to the second method. As I clean the chalkboard, as I clean this, I want us, those who are writing, you would be, I think you have just understood everything. You write after the lesson. So let me go to second method. The second method, method two, for us to identify the unit cost of each, we are going to say, we shall first of all look at the question. When you look at the question, now we are looking at method two. When we want to find out the amount that is spent on only 1 kilogram of a mixture, what we need to do is, first of all, we have to identify the types. We shall say, we shall also ask for permission, say, let the first type be A. So type A, how many kilograms did they mix? They were 5 kilograms. And remember, out of 5 kilograms, according to our question, they have said, Joy mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which cost 400 per kilogram. Meaning that only one, that's why they say per kilogram. In most cases, when they don't say per kilogram, they say per each. Sometimes they say each kilogram. Each kilogram and per kilogram is the same. You shouldn't get confused of the two words. So from there, we shall proceed and say, we shall say 1 kilogram of A. 1 kilogram of A costs how much? Type A, 1 kilogram costs 400. So we shall say 1 kilogram is costing us 400 francs. That is for one. But how many kilograms did this person mix? Mixed 5 kilograms. So if we mixed 5 kilograms, we shall now say, if 1 kilogram is giving us this, what about 5? Then 5 kilograms will be 5 times the amount for 1 kilogram, and that is 400 francs. Then it will give us 2000 francs. This is now the amount which was spent on type A only. Type A, she mixed 5 kilograms. Each kilogram was sold at 400. But if they were 5 kilograms which were mixed, then we shall have 5 kilograms multiplied by the unit cost, and the unit cost is 400. So we shall have 5 times 400, and the money we are coming out with here is the money that was spent on 5 kilograms which were mixed. So 5 kilograms will give us 2000. Then from there I'll say type B. I want us to look at type B. What happened with the type B? Type B, they said Joy mixed 5 kilograms of curry powder, which costs 400, that one we have finished, per kilo, with 10 kilograms of another type. Now that is our second type, 10 kilograms. This person bought a mixed 10 kilogram. Joy mixed 10 kilograms. But how much was 1 kilogram costing in the second type, or of the second type? The second type, each kilogram was costing 250 per kilo. So each was 250. So this is the unit price for type B. 1 kilogram is equal to 2,050. That's for only 1 kilogram. But how many kilograms did this person buy? Mix. Joy mixed 10 kilograms of flour, of curry powder. So if they were 10, we shall have 10 times 250 francs. When you get 10 times 250 francs, this will give us 2,500 francs. Now this 2,500 francs is the amount she spends, or which was allocated for type B. Then from there, we shall say mixture. We know now type A, we know type B. Now we don't know the mixture. What did she mix? What did she mix? This person here mixed type A. She mixed type A and type B. She mixed type A and type B. When she mixed type A and B, let's look at this. How many kilograms were there allocated on A? We had 5 kilograms. Kilograms, and B had 10 kilograms according to the question. So the mixture only was weighing 15 kilograms. That is the number of, those are the kilograms that the mixture was weighing. Because type A is 15, type B is 10. Then from there, we shall say amount of a mixture. Amount of a mixture. So total amount of a mixture. Total amount of a mixture. We shall get the amount spent on type A, that is 2,000 francs plus 2,500 francs. Where are we getting this amount? This is type A, this is type B, which will give us the sum of 4,500 francs. Now this is the amount that he spent on the mixture. A, type A is 2,000, type B is 2,500. So after getting 2,500, we shall get amount spent on A as 2,000, then we add the amount spent on B as 2,500, then the mixture will be for 4,500. After getting that amount spent on the mixture, now we want to identify how much was a kilogram. Remember, this money is for 15 kilograms. So we shall say he bought 15 kilograms, or he mixed 15 kilograms of how much? Of 4,500 francs. But how much is 1 kilo? 1 kilo of a mixture will be equal to 4,500 divided by the quantity. Quantity would be 15 kilograms. So I'll cancel 15, 1 by 15, 3. So 1 kilogram would be equivalent to 300 francs. Then from there, I'll get my Rwanda underline. This is what is supposed to be done according to the question, or according to finding, according to the area of today, whereby we are required to find the average price of mixtures. So when you look at the question and you look at the steps, we have two methods. You can choose the simplest that you feel it can work for you better. The one you feel it is suitable for you, the one you feel you understand much better. You don't just force yourself to use the method that you don't understand. So as I wind up with the first example, Before I switch to the second example, this would be my words to those who have just switched on their TV right now. Please always keep tuned to BTN TV for different programs that can really show us what is supposed to be done. We recognize this station as programs are concerned. Always stay tuned. Other vital programs or important programs or other useful programs are still coming in. Remember one thing, as we stay home, as we stay watching, we have to extend our initiative and we recognize BTN staff and the proprietors and the proprietor of Wisdom Center that came together and came out with this program to help our candidates outside there. So wherever we are, please stay tuned to them. You will always receive enough vital information that can help us move ahead, more so with the candidates. I encourage you to switch BTN TV from morning up to evening, such that you will be learning more ideas. You will be discovering more important programs. This TV is a TV station that really looks at the future of the child. That's why they had to come and sit with the different principals to come with this program to help our candidates outside there. Make use of it always. Let's go to example two. So let's look at the second example. I want us to rush and complete this second example, which says Chris mixed 20 kilograms of red beans at 200 francs each kilogram with yellow beans, which cost 400 kilograms per kilo, and form 50 kilograms of a mixture. Calculate the average price per kilo of a mixture. First of all, let's identify this. The red beans, how many were they? According to this, they said they mixed 20 kilograms of red beans, 20. So the mixture is equal to 20, whereby they said each kilogram was sold at 200. So unit cost would be 200 francs. That is now 1 kilo. Let's find out how much does this person spend on 20 kilograms. We shall say 20 times 200, which will give us 4,000 francs. Now this is the amount that was spent on red beans only. Then let's come and summarize with the second type. The second type, they said each kilogram with yellow beans, which costs 400. So we have another type here. They have not told us the quantity, but they have told us the amount that it was sold at, and that was 400 each. So if it was 400 each, they have said per kilogram, and form 50 kilograms of a mixture. So it formed 50 kilograms of a mixture. Now, we don't know how many kilograms were there on the second type. For us to find the kilograms which was on the second type, we know the mixture. So how many kilograms do you think they can add on 20 to give us 50? So we shall just simply get the mixture 50 kilograms minus 20 kilograms. So what we are finding here, we are going to find out the quantity of yellow beans, which will give us 30 kilograms. So yellow beans were 30 kilograms. And how much was it sold per kilo? Each kilogram was sold at 400. So we shall get 3 times 4, which will give us 12. 3 times 4, it will give us 12. Then from there, let's count the number of zeros that are included here. We have here 1, 2, 3. So we shall add here 3 zeros. So this becomes francs. So if the type of kilograms, if they bought yellow, 30 kilograms each was 400, then it means they spend 12,000 on 30 kilograms. Then from there, we shall continue with the question. They said, calculate the average price per kilogram of a mixture. So they want us to find out the average price, which is here. We don't know, but even here we don't know. So for us to find what is here, we first of all find the total amount that was spent on the two types, type A and type B. So type A, and we spent there 4,000. Type B, we spent there 12,000. So when you get 4,000 plus 12,000, what do we come out with? We shall first of all arrange it very well. We shall say this, we shall maintain francs. So get 4,000 plus 12,000. 12,000 plus 4,000, it will give us 1,000. It will give us 16,000. Let's see, we shall have our 4,000 aside there. Then at the same time, you'll have your 12,000. Remember, these zeros should be in the same column. Here, 0, here, 0, here, 0, here, 4 plus 2, 6, 1. So we shall have 16,000. After having 16,000, what shall happen? We shall now need to look for the amount that was spent on 1 kilogram. We know now this is the amount which was spent on all. So to find 1 kilogram, we shall say 50 kilograms. To find what is here, 1 kilogram unit cost, we shall just get what we have got last here as 16,000 divided by the number of kilograms that a mixture is carrying, and that is 50. So we shall say this zero goes with this zero by 5, 1 by 5, we shall have 3. 5 goes into this 3 times, then we shall have 1 here, 10 divided by 5, 2, then we shall have this 0 by 5, 0. So we shall come out with 3,200 francs. So this is the amount that was spent on only 1 kilogram of a mixture. That is what they are calling the average. So if this is our average, then right. Next time we shall look at how to find the quantity of one type or the price of one type. For today's case, for those who have just come late, you may also try to subscribe BTN TV channels. You'll find everything there. At the same time, in case you find like maybe you have any question relating to what I've covered, I refer you to the personal number. Send your question, it will be answered. Please stay tuned on BTN TV. For any question, please, I refer you there. Thank you.